AMD users can finally encode higher quality video using OBS Studio, as version 28 comes with an updated integration for AMD's AMF encoder on your graphics card, which lets you use B-frames. And a lot of you were sending me this post on Reddit with a bunch of commands to use B-frames and squeeze the most quality out of it. Only that post was wrong. Most of these settings were either just already defaults, things you can't change, things not in the implementation at all, or just shouldn't be changed in this way. So here's a guide for actually optimizing your AMD video encoder in OBS 28, albeit with there not being a ton to actually do. This video was sponsored by CuriosityStream. Help keep this documentation coming and get access to my own streaming site, Nebula, which has downloads to all the samples for this video bundled with CuriosityStream at the link below. All right, in case you missed it, a couple of weeks ago, I made a video detailing AMD's encoder updates that they finally released, allowing for the use of B-frames and some extra motion quality stuff. I also explain what all of that means, but effectively B-frames are just a type of reference frame that the encoder can use to help improve the quality of encoding as it moves through your video. But the results that we saw showed only one B-frame was worth using in the first place. Anything else resulted in worse quality, but it was an improvement. What I failed to mention was that B-frames apparently only even work on RX 6000 or higher GPUs, because AMD didn't document it, and it's not mentioned in their GitHub update. Yay. Sorry, I didn't know. So if you have an RX 6000 GPU, you can use B-frames with this new update. In the current beta, we have to manually add it, so I'm going to walk you through some commands both for RX 6000 and for older GPUs to optimize your settings. Jim, OBS's creator, has already said that he will add a UI element to control B-frames, so that, you know, we don't have to do this via text. I would honestly expect it to be in there by the full release of 28, so just use that if it's available when you watch this video. But everything else will still be manually adding. There's three main arguments that we're looking at for customizing your AMD encoder here, and you enter them in the Customs option box at the bottom of your AMD encoder settings. This will work for AMD HW, H.264, and H.265 in the new update, though we're primarily focusing on H.264 here, as these only really matter for low bitrate streaming, which is mostly going to be for Twitch, which doesn't support H.265. AMD's H.265/HEVC encoder already looks significantly better at low bitrates than H.264 anyway, if you are streaming to YouTube or whatever. Remember, you need an RX 6000 series GPU for B-frames, but the rest of the argument should work with most other generations, albeit with varying results, because the encoder just seems to act differently on different graphics cards. First, add max num ref frames equals 4 without spaces as shown on screen. This allows for up to 4 reference frames in general, not just B-frames, to be used. And in my last video on the AMD encoder, I did find that this had a desirable improvement on quality. Again, even if small. Now we get to some actual customization. B-frames are next. You actually need 3 arguments for B-frames. First is B-reference enable equals 1, which just tells the encoder to use them at all. Always have that on 1, since it's a boolean for true false, 0 is false, 1 is true. If you want B-frames, have it on 1. Next, we specify how many B-frames we want to use. Both in my full testing in the last video and in my samples for this one, best results seem to be with 1 B-frame almost universally, but you're welcome to play around with it if you like. In my testing, 1 looked better than 2, and 3, which is the max, actually caused too much encoding lag on our RX 6600 GPU in OBS to actually be usable, as it dropped 25 to 50% of the frames. So use max consecutive B pictures equals 1 and B pictures pattern equals 1 for 1 B frame, or replace it with 2 and both of those for 2 B frames. Technically, that first argument specifies how many B frames are used in a row, or the max that it can use in a row. So you could specify 2 in B pictures pattern, but then 1 in max consecutive and play around with it to still have a max of 2 B frames, but only use 1 in a row. You might get different results, but I wouldn't expect it to be worthwhile. Next up is pre-analysis. This is kind of like two-pass encoding. AMD's features are not documented well. In my limited testing here, having pre-analysis on seems to help preserve some detail and motion while reducing blocking, kind of makes it look more like the sharper details a teeny tiny bit, but it comes at the cost of some of the colors kind of smearing together. So you gain line detail while losing color detail. I think I'd leave it off personally, but I know some prefer it on, so to do this, use enable pre-analysis equals 1. Lastly, we have high quality motion boost. Throughout this whole video, I keep saying high quality motion boost. It's high motion quality boost. I've looked at this and mixed up these words for like 2 years now. I'll show it correctly on screen, but every time I say it wrong. I'm sorry. It's just where my mind goes, I guess. This was a feature added in the encoder a couple years ago after, I think, the RX 5000 series launched, but it isn't as significant as it sounds. It is off by default. You can add this with high quality motion boost enable equals one. But I would use one or the other here. HQMB on its own looks all right, preserving some details in motion for sure, like it's there, but pre-analysis and HQMB at the same time turns into a blurry mess. So for RX 6000 users, my recommendation would be max num ref frames equals 4, B reference enable equals 1, max consecutive B pictures equals 1, B pictures pattern equals 1, high quality motion boost enable equals 1. And for older AMD GPU users, I would recommend max num ref frames equals 4, high quality motion boost enable equals 1. And that's it. No commas, spaces between each argument, but not between the argument and the numbers. Again, in the full release, you can probably just use the UI to assign B frames and set a number for that, which will override the text anyway, most likely, and then just enter the HQMB pre-analysis and max ref frames arguments that you want in the text section. This won't magically make AMD's encoder great or compete with, you know, anyone else's, but it's a nice little quality bump that you can get for free. So why not? Here you go. Covering this OBS update, the AMD encoder update, and Intel's AV1 encoder has brought out a lot more support than I could have imagined the past couple weeks, and I just want to say thank you from the bottom of my heart. I have received a ton of requests to cover more ways to use, you know, the encoder optimization we did here, more ways to use the AV1 encoder, how to use HDR in OBS, which we started covering this week, all the different OBS update bits and everything you can imagine, and I'm getting there as quick as I can. But really, I'm only able to drop everything else and focus on this so significantly on the new developments thanks to your support over on Nebula. Nebula is my own creator-owned video streaming site where my videos are higher quality. They're ad-free, so you don't have to sit through these ads. And I include lots of either, you know, extended cuts or exclusive content or downloads, like the samples for this video, my AV1 samples and my AMD samples from the last video. All of that stuff is exclusive to Nebula, which is pretty cool that we get to do that and release this extra stuff to you all. The best way to sign up for Nebula is through the bundle that we've made with CuriosityStream, another awesome video site full of documentaries and great nonfiction work that you should definitely check out. I've been obsessed with all the new photos coming out of the James Webb Telescope, and CuriosityStream has a new show all about that very thing called First Images that you should definitely check out if you have been interested in the cool space stuff. Our bundle is priced more cheaply than most other video services that I've honestly seen on the market, as you get access to CuriosityStream's massive library and Nebula thrown in for free for under $15 per year. That's a lot of content for your dollar, a higher value than just about any other site. So sign up for the best deal in streaming at curiositystream.com/epos and help me continue to provide tons of thorough testing and documentation for you all on this kind of stuff. Links to the full documentation on this encoder update in OBS are linked below, along with a playlist full of my other OBS 28 coverage so far. I'm your stream professor, reminding you to be kind, rewind.